enterprise. We at TCS, we tried to intervene through our ICT platform called mKRISHI, and we were really taken back when I started interacting with farmers. Most of them, in one of my interesting meetings at Pimpalgaon Baswant in Nasik, which is one of the biggest onion market near Lasalgaon, farmer said that, sir, every time you change the company, as I have been changing the hats from Thermax to Entrepreneur and then to Reliance and British Petroleum and TCS, they say you come up with new product and try to enthrust that product onto us. Can we talk different? And when I was going there with this mobile technology to the farmers, they said, enough is enough. We have another 10 in the same space, but we are not happy. Why can't you put on our shoes? Why can't you look at our challenges and then maybe try to give us solutions? And then, of course, being in the sector, in the domain for almost now 22 years, we knew these challenges, but then we undertook a very exhaustive exercise and we conducted survey for 1,300 farmers. And I could club those challenges in these six major buckets. Competitive remunerative prices to his harvested produce is the most dear and most close to his heart. If you have a solution for that, we are for it. Access to institutional credit. Every 3 years, 4 years, there is a cycle. You will have good crops maybe for a year or two, but next 2 years could be excess water or drought. But you have to live 365 days a year. You have to have your meals, education, medical. And because somewhere I miss, as a farmer, I miss the bus, or I'm not able to get the desired productivity and production and returns, I get into that trap. And once or twice, these bankers would give me concession. But otherwise, I'm left with nothing, but I have to move to the money lender, and he charges me anywhere between 3% to 10% to 100% per season. Quality and timely agri inputs, yes. I go to dealer, he wants to maximize his profit, he will try to push something which he gets better returns on. Agriculture universities, beyond technical things, they don't provide what exactly is required by the individual at field level. They will only talk about technical names, they don't talk about the market trade names, and there is a disconnect. Improved technology, yes, I'm ready to adopt improved technology provided I get enough returns. Provided I get enough returns and I'm able to pay my EMI. And of course, improved technology is also directly proportional to your availability of labor. With urbanization and many other things, and thanks to NREGA, the average labor cost has gone up, and I'm not able to always get labor for maybe for planting, harvesting, and many other cultural activities. So he says that I'm ready to adopt technology provided I get better returns on my harvested produce, and so that I'm able to repay my EMI. And of course, Pani Jeevan Hai. With this climate change, everybody is worried about resilient agriculture. But if you don't have water, you can recreate everything. For agriculture, you can do multiple things. All the factors impacting agriculture can be managed somehow. But pani agar nahi hai, and when we are talking about millions and billions of farmers, unless and until we think through on this aspect, the challenge is big. So as a TCSer, as IT company, we realize that what we are trying to really achieve, through this mKRISHI platform, can we really deliver all these things? And if you look at these challenges and what I have to deliver, dur dur tak koi sambandh nahi hai. And that's where we really thought through. We said, and unless and until we start thinking holistically and we work with like-minded organization, may it be in government, may it be in private organizations, may it be NGOs, and then that is how this framework was created. And if you look at vertically, at the center of it is FPO, farmer producer organizations, or farmers, and of course horizontally it is B2B, may it be seed company, fertilizer company, and of course at that other end is exported produce, and vertically it is government and farming community. So we started working on this structure. Now, when we started thinking on this aspect, we realized that being an IT company, we cannot reach millions of farmers individually. And we felt that the right way of doing things was to get connected with, and we always statement was like, we will always be in B2B space. So we'll always engage with farmer organization, or maybe a dairy cooperative, or a processor, maybe like McCain or PepsiCo or somebody. And then, yes, we, as a TCS and affiliated companies, technology is our forte. We did everything in technology. We engaged with these organizations which has last mile connectivity. And the beauty is, wherever we engage with these organizations which has brick and mortar setup and last mile connectivity, the results have been very impressive. And that is how we set on to this thing. And if you look at the technology aspect of it, it is almost 10 years now that we are working on this aspect. And this is the basic slide of anything what we want to do. So there are some data points of an individual as a farmer or as a family. And we try to capture each and every aspect of every data point of there. It could be DBT to his bank account. It could be the number of people in his family. And as a farmer, what do I have? Maybe I have animal, cattle, and I have a plot of land. And you don't change your plot of land every often. So we literally take latitude, longitude of each and every farm. And we literally digitize farmer in all aspects. And yes, with this latitude, longitude, then we put the layer of agro weather. We are using UK agrometeorological weather data, as well as we are also using IMD database. And then this, yes, behind the scene starts the IT. If you look at the overall growth of any crop, so it starts with crop selection and ends at market intelligence, and in between through technology, and not only technology, but through field force on the field, we try to provide intermittent periodical advisory. And we not only provide the advisory, which is proactive, but also ensure that the farmer is adopting it and working on it. So these are the two sides, and just I will run through the how it is done. So farmer, with all his data digitized, we can guide the farmers what crop, what options he has, which could give him the best returns. Of course, once we are always working through B2B space, so we call prides. Our objective is how we can transform these traditional farmer producer organizations or cooperatives into next generation progressive rural integrated digital enterprises. As an IT company, I talk about CMM5 and Sigma 6. So we would also like to transform this organization into next level organizations of excellence. And once the crop is selected, collectively farmer can give the order to the distributor or maybe the company, and his produce can be distributed to him through the organization. And then, of course, crop cycle management, we are using various technologies, teacups, crops. And then, of course, satellite drones we are using. So all different technologies, some of them are matured, some of them are being worked for only for research purpose. And of course, we are also traceability, and all aspects are taken care of. We are almost working with 37 such agriculture organizations which are into exports. And then yes, harvest planning. Our objective is to how we can transform these normal farmer producer companies into demand driven agriculture production. And some of the experiments are, we are working towards it. And we are getting some success by interacting and collectively working with quite a lot of retailers like More, Reliance Retail, and our own Star Bazaar. So how we are doing it? Agronomist or we have a project manager and field staff. Those are connecting with the farmers in the vicinity of 30, 40 villages. And so that the first is forward and backward linkage. See, the first challenge, if you look at what the farmer is really interested in, is harvested produce. And that's the biggest challenge. It is not that easy a problem to solve. Working in this domain for almost 20 years, including being a sabjiwala for almost 3 years, I know what are the challenges of perishable produce. And so our engagement is in big way across the country, So this is end-to-end model. So what are the requirements of the farmer? We are now about to start a project with the State Bank of India, wherein State Bank says that any farmer wanting a crop loan can just, like you and me, get our home loan or personal loan. We are trying to make the process seamless and effortless so that within 24 hours, the money could be brought into his account. And not only that, once, what is for how the crop loan is defined? There are different activities during the crop growth stage, and he is given amount according to his requirement. And that is where we are bringing in the, once the, and credit is very critical. Please understand, credit is very critical. Once the bank gives the loan, we are also trying to provide various facilities to the farmer so that he can choose the which input he wants to go in for. And many of the companies are interested in providing him the inputs in advance, which could cost him or which could save his at least 30 to 35% of the money on the inputs. Similarly, credit, agriculture insurance, and other things. And of course, once the produce is harvested. So these are the challenges. It's not that easy to come through. But yes, we have started the journey. We started when we actually wanted to work with these farmer producer companies and cooperatives. We could not be just fence sitters. So we started with 7 of the farmer producer companies. I miserably failed while establishing first. But I'm proud to say that the journey which we started 3.5 years before, now we are working with almost 750 such organizations across the country, from Gujarat till Tripura, and from Srinagar and Kupwara till Kanyakumari. And in short, that was it. Thanks a lot.